but we're still getting the same look because the B route still has an inside release. And now you'll see how the B route is still wide open over the top the exact same way. It's just going to be a diversion, and this RB route here is going to get outside. As you can see, we should be able to get a catch and run play touchdown with the running back, giving you three different ways to score on this play. As you can see, nobody covers this guy after about 20 yards. I mean, there is so much space there. You could score from anywhere on the field. For the fastest, cheapest, most reliable coins on the market, check out my coin sponsor, MMOXP.com, and use discount code MONEYSHOT to get 5% off your order. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Still with the Man and Cheese, as always. Got another full breakdown video for you guys today. This is something that I've been doing for some time now on Fridays, and it's been very successful. Me putting out full breakdowns of offenses or defenses that I've been using in gameplay, or that I'm planning on using in a gameplay coming up, which is what I'm doing today. Last week, I did it with a 3-4 odd, and then obviously I've been putting out gameplays about a 3-4 odd. It's just a way that if you watch my gameplays and you want to see more from the offenses or defenses I'm using, I can basically link you guys right back to this video, and then you can learn the entire scheme, because there's only so much that I can show in a gameplay. And I think that you guys are liking this, because like I said, these are performing really well on Fridays and throughout the weekend. So today I'm going to be showing you a brand new offense out of my Denver Broncos offensive ebook one more time, and the formation is going to be the single back tight Y off. Now, this is in a lot of different playbooks, but the Broncos have a very unique version where they have two plays that can basically hit a one play touchdown against every single defense in the game, and it's coming from two very different receivers. It's the PA post dig, where you have it coming from the right side, or the PA deep cross, where you have it coming from the left side, making it very difficult for your opponent to pick up which direction you're trying to attack. But basically, this entire offense since the patch has really opened up the run game a lot more since the October 4th patch that I talked about a lot in my videos. So to me, running the ball from under center is really back in a big way, which is why I like using formations like this and formations like my I form close, which I put out a full breakdown about a couple weeks ago. I do plan on switching playbooks, so let me know in the comments section what playbook you guys would like to see me use next, because I don't think I'm going to be using the Broncos for too much longer, based on the fact that I want to try to use some of my other ebooks that I put out. I plan on using the Jets playbook next, and then I'm also working on the Niners and the Ravens behind the scenes, which are going to be my next two playbooks after that. So let me know in the comments section if you guys have a preference which ebooks or which playbooks you'd like me to use or put out in the future. Other than that, let's get right into the video. If I can go back and find the single back tight way off, this has a couple of really good run plays, so I guess I'll start off with that. But I'm going to first start off with my audibles, because this is pretty much going to be my setup when I run this online. Now, my four play audibles would be the PA post dig, which I just mentioned. It's a one play touchdown against every defense in the game from one direction, and then the PA deep cross, which is a one play touchdown against every defense in the opposite direction, but also has a really good route, which is that the red route is running, that I'll go over later. You got the jet sweep, which is probably the best outside run, as far as, you know, this doesn't really have a stretch run in the formation, but the jet sweep's a very good run against a lot of different defenses. And then you got the halfback zone weak, which is going to act like your all-purpose run. This can be used as an inside run, an outside run. It can be used as your replacement for the stretch, which is obviously important to most of the schemes that I run. But this one here is very versatile, so it's really the only run play that you need. Then when it comes to my fifth play, I have a lot of different options, but I would say that my fifth play, or my active play, would typically be the bench switch, because this one here has the most capability as far as dinking and dunking. But there's a lot of really good dink and dunk plays that I'll go over in a minute. Let's start off, though. There are a lot of good run plays in this formation, so we're going to start off with that, and I'll start off with the zone weak, because this is kind of the star of the running scheme. Now, before getting to the video, if you guys want more help, you can instantly download these or any of my ebooks simply by clicking links in the description or the top pinned comment. Now, when it comes to running the ball in this formation, if you see an opportunity, you can always flip the run play and just run it as is. But I find it's best to try to utilize some motions to create bunch concepts with either the receivers or with the tight end. Now, if I motion this guy across and it's a zone coverage, you can see how nobody follows, and it gives me a bunch look that instantly creates a blocking advantage for me in that direction. So there you can see I can take it outside, get behind that bunch, get an easy 5 yards. I find it's best to typically motion across the tight end, but I also try to, you know, be versatile. I also try to sometimes motion over the receivers just so my opponent can't really pick up on what I'm doing. This play here, though, I'm probably not going to have to get it to the outside, although you can see that block was totally missed by the receiver. If you want better blocking, you can put a tight end at the Y receiver, because all the explosive pass plays are going to come from the outside receivers anyway, so that's really up to you. I'll actually back out and I'll do that real quick. The only downside to doing this is that you won't actually, I'll put Albert Okwuegbunam, who's like my fastest tight end. The only downside to doing that is it might have give you a, it's going to give you a slower option when it comes to the jet sweep that I mentioned earlier. So you would just have to try to, work between the two. But now I have several advantages where, number one, if my opponent isn't in a 3-4 or a 4-3 at least, the way that this game works now is they won't have the benefit of the adaptive AI. So putting a, if I'm going to run this a lot, putting a tight end at the wide receiver spot is going to open up, it's going to take away the adaptive AI, which is kind of important in this year's game. So now that I'm looking at a nickel package on defense, you can see how, number one, that tight end did a much better job of blocking that defensive end, as I'm trying to get at least one run play to the outside so I can show you guys how this wall of blockers can set up now that I have two tight ends here. I just need that first block to hold up. As you can see right there, he's not holding up. So I want to put a better blocking tight end like Jack Stoll, who is like my best blocking tight end on the offense, other than maybe, Goddard, which I'm not even getting to him because he's just, there we finally get that look where we can get outside. So, like I said, that's something where you can use this play as an inside run, or you can take it outside behind the wall of blockers if your tight ends do a good enough job of holding this spot down here. If nobody gets through, you can always redirect. You can see right here, I just basically sprint to the outside, and then I'm just getting to the edge, and it's a foot race, So that's really one of the better ways to run this play. Now, the only other run that I would really use would be the jet sweep. But like I said, if I'm going to use this play, it's probably going to be best to have your fastest receiver. But I'm going to run it with Albert Okwuegbunam because I think he's fast enough. And we're going to go random. Like I said, this year, you pretty much only want to use this if it's like a man coverage. You can see, like I said, a little bit more speed would be nice, but I got strength as I get that guy off, and I still get 5 yards. It's always going to be better to run this with a receiver, but I do like the benefit of having the two blocking tight ends, and I keep this in my audibles because there will be times where I'm going to want to switch to this. The looks where I want to switch to this are typically going to be like man coverage looks, cover three, cover four. This is a perfect look here because you can see that this receiver will most likely pull these guys back and give me an opportunity to get outside, and you can see that worked out like that just perfectly. So even though I don't have my fastest receiver here, I have my fastest tight end here, and it's still being successful. So now that we got through the run plays, I'm gonna do some dink and dunk plays, but I'm gonna save the one play touchdowns for last, which is typically what I do. There's a very good man beating play. We'll just start at the top here, the PA deep curls. So if this play here, both of the outside routes are just good man beating routes, as they'll just stop right in front of the cornerback and come back. The only way that your opponent will be able to stop this play is if they shade underneath, which can be, a good option, but it's also going to, they will try to cut off these routes, but it's also going to make them susceptible to streaks. So if they do that, just put one on a fade and leave one alone. And if they start shading underneath, you'll be able to hit the streak for a big play. So there's really no downside here, but you can see how that play is just going to be open all day. And it's about a 15-yard route every single time. Probably the best play against zone coverage is going to be the bench switch. So we went ahead and picked random again. You can run this play just like this. These the underneath routes, the 5 yard out routes are going to be very good against man coverage and zone coverage. And I can really just split the field in half and read the play just like this. As you can see, these tight ends are going to get open for big plays to the outside. You can just run it like that. There's another way to run this, and I think it'll typically be best if you run it from a hash mark to the short side of the field when it comes to zone coverage. Now, if I run it from a hash mark like this, there is a bit of a glitch where you can put the Y route on a streak. I call it the hash marks glitch, and the X route here, the corner route, will get open against just about any zone. So I don't really have a man beater on that side of the play. So if I want to make it a read where I can really just read one side of the field, all I got to do is put the A route on a drag, and now I got a dragging check down versus man or zone. And then I can put the B route on a 10-yard in route and have another check down. Now, I'm not really sure what this coverage is. It looks like a man coverage, but you can see that this X route's just covered. It's just blanketed. Corner routes aren't too great against man coverage. So that's why you have the other two routes, which will come in handy. This here looks like a cover two, though, so I'm guessing actually it wasn't. It looks like it was actually a zone. You can see how this guy gets wide open. Any zone coverage, that guy's going to get wide open. Just make sure you throw it before you get too close to the boundary, because a lot of quarterbacks will throw that ball out of bounds in Madden 24. But this year, hopefully we got a, now we definitely have a zone coverage, cover two. And you can see how against cover two, that could be a very big play. I mean, that could be a potential one play touchdown if you have a fast enough receiver. Now, you do have another option here, and I'll move the ball to the other side because I want to work to the receiver side. You can also run this to the open side of the field and motion one of these guys across and work it like a bunch concept. So basically, this would be your classic bunch concept. You have a streak, you have a flat, and then you have your X route. One of these three is going to get open. Now, typically against a lot of zones, it's going to be the B route right away, which I'll steal all game. That was close to 10 yards, and it really didn't, you know, take much for me at all. So you could do that. You could also put the B route on a streak and put the Y route on a flat. I find that it's best to do it the other way, though, because you can see the free release that this guy gets, and I can just throw that out. It's almost like a bubble screen. If you see a cover three or cover four, it's just a simple quick hit, and you're getting a lot of yards. Even if it's cover two, this kind of looks like it might be a cover two. So I'll go ahead and I'll do that. Although realistically, cover two, if it is, I'm gonna wait for that X route to get open, and you can see her once again. I mean, this guy's just open all day in the flat. That time I got almost 15 yards, or over 15 yards. So that's really one way to do it. But this is, you know, this is pretty much your setups. You have a couple of different options here. If I wanted to go full setup, I'd say I'd once again put the A route on a drag, because I don't necessarily have a great man beater on this concept. You can see here once again, anytime I got that guy, I'm going to take it. It's not that difficult. And you can see how you can just get some easy catch and runs. I'm getting more and more yards every time. I'm getting close to 20 yards now. So that would definitely be my favorite concept there. And then you also have the running back, which is a really good check down on a check and release. So that's it for the dink and dunk plays from this. So I'm going to go ahead and get into the one play touchdowns, but I'm not going to start with these two plays. I'll show you guys these in a minute. I'm going to show you some one play touchdowns you can get out of the bench switch first, as this play here has a one play touchdown option against cover zero. So basically, this doesn't need any additional setup. You just have this this route here, which is a very good man-beating route. It's not necessarily like that on the other side. The route on the other side doesn't necessarily break the same way. We'll try that. You always want to run these to the open side of the field, because the catch and run space is really what makes it a one play touchdown. But you can see here, they are different routes. The route that the X route is running is not actually the same. And you can see he's all over that, even with a better receiver in AJ Brown. Now, that only really works against man zero. It doesn't work against any other man coverage. But we also have cover two, which I already mentioned, and even cover three. So let's go and let's pick cover two next. Against cover two, if you streak the A route, put the Y route on a drag, which I already mentioned, can be a one play touchdown. You can see how you can have a very big play. Although realistically, it all depends on how that safety bites on the tight end. I don't think my tight end's fast enough to pull him down. I could try to run it to the other side. I think Akwae Bunam might be a little bit faster than Goddard. Plus, he's not in line like Goddard is. So it'll probably be better to run it to the other side, because this Y route has a more free release. And now you can see how I can really just turn this up the field. And as long as I get a better catch and run animation than I got there, it might be able to be gone. Go ahead and I'll do it one more time. Like I said, the tight end behind the line of scrimmage there is not necessarily the best option. But you can see how you can really get a play here as we finally get that one play touchdown, so we can move on to the next coverage. This play can also be successful against cover three in a very different way than the way I'm going to show you in the next couple plays. So let's go and let's pick cover three sky. Now, for this play to work, you will have to go back to three wide receivers. You can't necessarily have this play work with a tight end at the Y receiver spot. So for this to work, all you got to do, put the Y route on a fade, the A route on a streak, and motion out Brown. And you'll see how this will stretch the field, as I can really get up the seam now from the safety. You also want to run from a hash mark to the open side of the field, or else it won't work out this way. But you'll be able to see how this safety really can't choose between the two, and they can just bullet and pass lead outside for a very easy one play touchdown up the seam. This is probably my favorite cover three one play touchdown. This play can also have success against cover four. Matt, so let's go and pick that. Against cover four, all you gotta do is motion this guy across and put the Y route on a streak. I'm also gonna put the A route on a 10-yard out route, because I want to try to hold those two deep defenders on that side as long as possible, as they're trying to figure it out. But all this is really gonna do is confuse the defense to the point where the X route just gets right past his man defender, as he just shoots in like he's, you know, like he doesn't know who he's supposed to cover right away. I'm not really sure, but cover four is pretty easily glitched out. Now, a streak isn't necessary. I actually think it's better to probably just put the Y route on a 10-yard curl, because that's going to make sure that he doesn't pull any defenders back to the point where they can really you know, come back into play to try to tackle AJ Brown. It really puts this guy in a position where he's the only one that can tackle AJ Brown, where a streak will pull a defender back. So I would say it's best to leave it like this, to just have him on a 10-yard curl, so that he at least holds somebody, because any route over 10 yards is going to get that type of treatment. And you can see how he's just burning Snead, even though Snead's a much faster cornerback. He's just beating him every single time. Now, I wanted to focus on those routes because those are outside routes, where the next couple of plays I'm going to show you have inside routes that beat everything, starting with the PA post dig. So let's go and let's pick that. On the defensive side, we're going to continue to start off with cover two like we typically do. So we'll go cover two. These are very easy. All you got to do is put the A route here on a streak, and I'm going to put the X route on a 10-yard out route, although A.J. Brown is different, so I always forget that. Might take him off that spot just because of how annoying that's going to be. But you could see how, you know, the tight end probably could have scored there as they're both just wide open. The 10-yard out route splits the safeties apart. It's a very easy play, especially since I'm running from a hash mark. You could also motion this guy across. This route here is a very good route to the outside. If I'm going to do this, I'm going to want to, like, put Goddard in, like, a check and release or something else because that blocking setup system really doesn't work. But the B route here against cover two is going to be a even better route than the corner route that I was showing in the previous play, as I'll probably have a better opportunity for a catch and run one play touchdown to the outside with this particular route. Now, if I do this particular route, there's a couple ways. I mean, I could really just block Goddard before I motion him across, because if I block him from here, he'll stay in a more traditional pass block look than that whatever it was he's doing there. So he's still pass blocking. So make that adjustment before you motion him across. That's the easiest way to do it. I also find putting the B route on a smart route is probably the best way to do it, because that's going to shorten it. He's going to go open a little bit quicker, and I find that's going to be a little bit more successful when it comes to the end result here, which is trying to get this one play touchdown, which I'm so close, as I'm going to try to do it one more time. Got to get this one play touchdown at least once. I think putting the Y route on a streak might also help. So let's go and let's see what happens now, because he'll pull him a little bit more inside, and now you can see we get that one play touchdown finally from 50 yards out. We picked Tampa 2. Now we'll pick cover 2 man, and it's pretty much going to be the exact same setup. Just got a streak to tight end, put the X route on a 10-yard out route, which I keep forgetting. AJ Brown has additional wide receiver adjustments, but we're still getting the same look because the B route still has an inside release, and we get a very easy one play touchdown up the middle against cover two. You can still do the other one as well, though. I'll put Goddard on a block before I motion him across. Then I'll put the Y route on a streak once again, although the X route here is kind of getting in the way. So I'm going to put him in a zig just to give myself a check down. And now you'll see how the B route is still wide open over the top the exact same way, and the safety still has to respect that streak. So streaking the inside receiver definitely is the way to go. Pick that again, only now we're going to switch up. We'll continue to do some man coverage. We're going to do cover one hole. Cover one hole is pretty much the exact same way, although I find it's best to probably streak the A route this time to try to pull that guy across. I'll give myself a dragging check down, but the B route's going to work the exact same way, as this route here just does a really good job of getting over the top of defenders. So it's just a really good route to that side. But you could also motion this, you know, if you run the ball from a hash mark to the short side of the field, you can have success. This is going to be another scenario where I'm just going to put the A route on a streak, and I'm going to smart route that B route just so he crosses the field a little bit quicker. But this is pretty much going to be it. The B route here, once he crosses that guy's face, is going to be another easy wide open one play touchdown, even though that was an under pressure short throw that I still was wide open enough to catch. This really only works if you're running from a hash mark to the short side of the field, though, because otherwise the safety is going to usually help out too much. But this is a very easy setup. Next up, we also got cover zero. Cover zero is pretty much the same way. The B route here, any post route lining up inside the defender like that is going to be a very easy one play touchdown. I didn't even have to worry about my blocking setup because the blocking setup's all pretty much there. You can put the tight end on like a check and release drag just so that he does block for a moment, but you can see that actually messed up the entire thing. So it's best to just leave it as is, because the tight end does do a pretty good job even with that funky fake run look to get me buy me some time. And if I change that, it actually messes everything up. So very easy one play touchdown against cover zero. Next up, we'll do cover three. Now you can score one play touchdown against cover three as well, but I prefer the one up the seam a little bit more because you don't have to wait as long. For this to work though, just motion this guy out, put him on a comeback route, put the A route on a streak, and then the running back on a wheel. And this is going to be the setup. You have to run from a hash mark like this, just kind of like the cover one version that I mentioned earlier. But you can see how once this guy gets inside the safety, he has an opportunity for a one play touchdown against cover three. Like I said, I prefer the seam beater because it's a little less time than waiting for this guy to cross the safety, but it's still a cover three one play touchdown as well. Next up, we'll do cover four, starting with cover four quarters, cover four match. Now for cover four, there's a really easy way to glitch this out. Just motion this guy across, put the A route on a streak, and then put the Y route on a streak, and you'll see how the Y route just gets completely disregarded. As you can see, there's just nobody. It just splits the middle of the field, and there's about 20 yards of distance to the closest defender. I could score from anywhere on the field with this. This is one of the easier defenses to glitch out, but it's even easier when you have three receivers on one side of the field. As you can see, nobody covers this guy after about 20 yards. I mean, there is so much space there. I could score, if somebody makes a mistake running cover four against this, you could score from anywhere on the field. The hardest defense to score one play touchdown against, though, is typically going to be cover four regular. So we're going to pick cover four drop contain. So I'm just going to run from the hash mark to the short side of the field, motion out the B route, put the running back on a wheel, the X route on a curl, and the Y route on a drag. And this is all you really got to do. And this will give you an opportunity to hit this B route once he clears the safety there. As you can see, we get a very easy one play touchdown. So that's every setup for the PA post dig. But now, if your opponent starts to key in on that side of the field, you can always just switch sides of the field to the other side with the PA deep cross. So let's go and let's pick that. On defense, we're just gonna start off with random. So this play here, I chose random because there's actually a lot of really good plays you can do with just this B route. All you gotta do is put the X route on a streak and put the A route on a drag or a 5 yard in. And either him or the crossing B route will get open against just about any defense. The crossing B route is probably up the most. If you're running a lot out of this formation, it will suck the user linebacker down and make it even easier. But you don't really have to put the X route on the street. He's running post, which is pretty much good enough. I find the street better. You can also lengthen these routes if you need like a really long distance. You can smart route them both. And now the in route's running about 12 yards, where the B route's running about 30 yards. And most zone drops won't be going that far. But you can see here, once he breaks inside, there's nothing really there. And it's an explosive route. I mean, I got a 50-yard one play touchdown, what looked like a cover one hole. So a very good play there that you can run pretty much any time. You could also motion this guy across. I've showed this as well in my I-form close scheme. Same principles apply. I mean, you can put him on a deeper route. You know, most people are running, I know, and some people are running 30-yard drops. This is dropping to about that distance as my throat's getting all clogged up. But like I said, you can see how this route, I don't know what that was, looked like a man coverage. Once again, getting open about 30 yards. And it's just a really hard to stop route. It's one of the better routes in the game. We'll do cover two. We'll start off with Tampa 2 regular, Tampa 2 zone, wherever that is, if I can find it. There we go. And the setups are going to be very similar. All I'm going to do is put the Y route on a streak and the B route on a 10-yard out route. I kind of like this one better, though, because at the very least, I have a free release with the Y route on this side of the field compared to the other play where the tight end was never really getting a free release. So this year actually feels like it's going to be a lot easier of a one-play touchdown setup because of that. That setup also works against cover two man, but there's a better one. So if I want to do it from here, from a hash mark to the open side of the field, now I have those two routes are just going to be a diversion. And this RB route here is going to get outside. As you can see, we should be able to get a catcher and one play touchdown with the running back. So that's something if your opponent really starts paying attention to that post route. Put the Y route on the streak, B route on a 10-yard out route. And because this X receiver is inside at the start of the play, he's just going to be going the exact same way. That 10-yard out route's going to pull the safeties apart, and you get a very easy one play touchdown in multiple ways once again. We'll continue with man coverages. We'll go back to cover zero first. All you really got to do is change what the tight end's doing. And you can see how this post route just gets open right up the middle once again. Because that's what post routes do. They're going to beat any. It already has inside leverage. Because you start this play with inside leverage on the cornerback, he's going to get across that cornerback every single time. So you can throw this ball pretty much right away and have a very easy one-play touchdown. You can also have success against cover one. We already saw the B route beat cover one, so let's just put the Y route on a streak and run it as is, and you'll see how this X route here will have success crossing that safety once again, as long as they run from a hash mark to the short side of the field. And even though they got caught up, you can see that was just an animation that kept me out of the end zone, but still an easy one-play touchdown against cover one. Next up, we'll do cover three. Same setup as before, just going to put the B route on a comeback route, put the Y route on a streak, get a motion out of the B route, run from a hash mark to the short side of the field like I am here. And the X route here is going to be gone the second he gets inside the safety for another easy one-play touchdown. And I actually probably threw it a little bit early. I probably could have waited as the cornerback was nowhere to be found. Next up, we'll do cover four, starting with cover four quarters, cover four match. For this play here, just put the Y route on a streak and then the A route on a curl. And the X route's going to be gone for a very easy one-play touchdown because the cornerback, it turns into his responsibility and he's just way out of position. And last but not least, we got a cover for Roto Regular, which unsurprisingly is going to be the same setup because it's basically the same thing, but we'll go cover for a drop and tame. So another play where I'm going to run from a hash mark, put the Y route on a fade, put the A route and the B route on curls. I'll go on a motion out the B route just to basically, I'll put him on a comeback because that'll be even better. The curl there is meant to hold that safety down and it totally failed, but that's okay because we're trying to get over the cornerback anyway. And you can see how we can dot that up in the corner. So that's pretty much one way to do it, but I already showed a different way with the other play. So I'm gonna go ahead and end the video there. If you guys wanna see more breakdowns like this in the future on Fridays, please make sure to be a subscriber, hit the like button in the comment section. Other thanks for watching, man. Need more help or just wanna show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below.